is a lamp unto my feet and a light.
Greetings to all who are now watching. So we are now going to resume the word that we are studying at, again, to remind us, ito po ating pinag-aaralan came from the acronym COVID. So we're done with the letter C, which is change. And we're also done with the O. And we're going to discuss letter V, which is victorious living. Yesterday, as we have discussed overcoming, or a Christian should be an overcomer. When a Christian become an overcomer, then that's the time he will experience the victory that God had given to us. We cannot experience the victory unless we become or we became an overcomer. So this afternoon, we're going to focus on the victorious living. So we become an overcomer, then we experience victorious living. Now, what are the things that we need to do in order for us to live a victorious life? Nandun na po tayo sa stage. We are experiencing the victory that God has given us. Now, what are the things we need to do in order to maintain our victorious Christian life? In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 57 and 58, this is where we get a text from our discussion this afternoon. Allow me to read it to you. 1 Corinthians again, 15, or chapter 15, verse 57 to 58. The word of the Lord says, "But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." Verse 58, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." Let his name be praised as we have read his word. Now, Paul is exhorting, or the Paul had written this letter to the book, church in Corinthians. And prior to this verse that we have read this afternoon, he's talking about the final victory that we have in Christ, where Jesus were going to take us out from here on earth. Okay, ito tinutukoy niya is talking about the rapture. Okay, but the thing is, Paul is general in telling the believers, "But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." Even the rapture is not yet, not yet come, okay? We can experience living in a victorious one, okay? And here, we should be thankful because God is the one who gave us the victory. He allows us or enables us to be an overcomer. Of course, God is doing His part, then we should do our part as well. Kinakailangan gawin natin ang ating bahagi. May kasabihan nga, nasa Diyos ang awa, nasa tao ang gawa. As believers, we should learn to live a victorious life because this is the will of God for us to do. Now, victorious living is what we should be desiring of. Ito po ang dapat nating pakanasain every day of our life. As we all know, we are experiencing in our Christian life journey a lot of things, of which we can say that in this course of our Christian life journey, we have this what we call the ups and downs of Christianity. I mean, sometimes we are above and sometimes we became low. I'm not saying that mali yun, it's all part of our life. But the thing is, we maintain it by listening to the Word of God and applying the Word of God in our life. Nami-maintain natin to. So ito pong gusto ng Panginoon sa atin, even though our daily lives is full of difficulties, challenges, but we must again have this mindset to live our life victoriously. wala naman masasabi na sa buhay ng isang tao ay lahat dire-diretso lang. Kahit na mayaman ang isang tao, even though a rich person is experiencing difficulties in life as well. Pare-pareho lang tayo. But the thing is here, as believers, I'm talking about as believers, we are now become an overcomer and we are experiencing the victory that Christ has given to us, and we must continue in that life that God has provided to us. And how? Papaano? There are three things that I would like to share to you. How to live a victorious life. Number one, Paul said, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast. So number one is, be steadfast. Steadfast means loyal. It means faithful, committed. Mga kapatid, brethren, beloved brethren in the Lord, stay loyal with God. Stay faithful in Him. Regardless of what is happening in our life, especially right now, stay your faith in God. Even in moments like these, we should remain faithful. Huwag tayong paghinaan ng loob. Many of us, maybe, when the quarantine period started, some of us are still happy. We have some resources to get. But as days is coming or passing by, the quarantine has been extended for quite a few days. What if the quarantine period will be extended a little bit more? Our attitude or our behavior must remain in the situation that we must be able to remain loyal in our faith in Christ. Huwag tayong panghinaan ng loob. There are a lot of Christians that napanghihinaan sila ng loob. Their heart is experiencing depression, kalungkutan. Especially those who are, you know, if you have a family church and then the destino kasi isang malayong lugar, let's say in abroad. A lot of Christians I have watched and talked to them, napanghihinaan sila ng loob. Why? Kasi daw sila ay nalayo sa kanilang family church. But in our case, as a victorious Christian or an overcomer Christian, we should not be faint of what we are experiencing in life. Even though na kayo malayo, even though na wala tayong physical church right now that we're usually having before, we should stay strong. I would like to give you an example, the example of John. When he wrote the book of Revelation, he was in the island of Patmos. As we all know, the island of Patmos, it is a forbidden place, they call it. Lots of prisoner was thrown there, and some of them died because of loneliness, because you are the only person might be living in that place. That is, they call a banished place, wherein there might be some inhabitants or mayroong mga nag-stay doon, but it's a place wherein it's very gloomy, the first place. There are skulls or skeletons of those who have lived there and died. Something that is, John was put in a place wherein he doesn't have anyone to talk with. But he remained loyal and committed to our dear Lord Jesus Christ. Kaya, I do not see, even if you are far away, or even if we don't have a physical church as of the moment, or wherein we can have our services, but praise God, we have this media, we have this technology right now that we can have online services. Alam niyo, mapalad na tayo eh. In other countries which are communist countries, they don't allow services to be held through medias or like this, Facebook. But we are blessed. Still, we can make use of medias. We can still connect with one another. We can still have Bible studies with one another. We can share our faith with one another because of this technology that we have. So we are blessed. So I don't find any reason that our heart will fail because we don't have a structure. Remember, the true church is not a structure. The true church or the body of Christ is you and me, those who have been bought by the blood of Jesus. We are the church. We are the body of Christ. We are the bride of Christ. We are the believers. Church, the word church comes from the word ecclesia, means the called out ones. It's not the structure itself. It's a building. But we are the church of Jesus Christ. And the church of Jesus Christ must live victoriously. Remain. Be faithful in God. Paano natin mapapakita na tayo faithful and committed sa Panginoon? If we have services like this, that's one example we can have or attend, or we can join, we can participate. Not only by listening, but not only by watching, but we can even share it with our loved ones. We can share it with those people whom we consider friends. We can share it abroad. This might inspire them as well. So there are a lot of ways wherein we can be steadfast in our victorious living. You know, the devil is trying to bombard our minds with doubts. I believe that walang isang taong Kristiyano na manghihina. Itapon ka man sa malayong lugar. Wala ka fellowship with one another. Wala ka media, wala ka cellphone. But it doesn't mean na manghihina ka. I don't believe that. I believe that if you have the word of Jesus in your life, you will be strong. Why? Because the word of God is the one who strengthens us. Manghihina ka kung wala ang pastor? No, it's not. Jesus is the great shepherd. Ang Panginoon natin is the great shepherd. Maiwan man tayo ng ating mga mahal sa buhay, maiwan man tayo ng ating mga loved ones malalapit sa atin, but Christ says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. This is one of the 5 minutes devotion. And please watch that because your faith will be strengthened as well. So, if you are a victorious Christian or an overcomer, you should live a steadfast faith in God. Stay loyal. Stay faithful. No matter what will happen. Okay? So that's number one. Number two, Paul says, immovable. Immovable, when I check it out in the online dictionary, it says, not able to move. The meaning is using the same word, but I believe when we talk about immovable, it means unshakable, meaning no one or nothing in this earth can move you. Because of your faith in God, you will be able to withstand whatever things that might come to you. Regardless of whatever nasty things comes into your life, you can face it heads up, meaning you are victorious in Christ. Victory is there already. Jesus has provided the victory. What we do is to overcome it in our daily life. And that's how we're going to live our life victoriously in God. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 and 27, let me allow me to read it to you. Matthew 7:24. I love this verse. And this verse is usually being preached many times, and this is something that we need to remember. Matthew 7:24 to 27. Therefore, whoever hears the sayings of mine, and Jesus is speaking this, therefore whoever mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on the rock. Jesus is telling us a wise is the one who built his house round foundation, a rock. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. So when a house was built on a rock, not on a soil, not on a sun, it will withstand whatever things that might come, rain, flood, storm. It will stand because the ground is solid. The same thing with us believers. If you are reading the Word of God daily in your life, I mean to say daily, not occasional or not or maybe 2 days after, consider God's Word as a food, a spiritual food for our soul. Okay? Pag hindi ka nakakain ng isang araw, manghina ka, di ba? You will feel weak. Just the same as true with the Word of God. We should take it daily. Busyness in life is there already. It's given. It's not a problem. It's given. We cannot say, I'm too busy in my work. I wasn't able to read the Word of God. No, it's not. Because the Word of says in Psalm chapter 1, blessed is a man who meditate the Word of the Lord day and night. Not only day, but day and night. He is like a tree planted by the rivers of living water, and the waters will come, and he or the tree will not go along with the water. It will be strong. It will be grounded in a solid ground, like the house where a wise man had built. So you will be immovable when the Word of the Lord is there in your heart. Again, those you might be far away from your loved ones, you might be far away, you don't have any means to hear, read the Word. You have the Bible. You have the things that you need to read the Word of God. Meditate His Word and you will be strong. Okay? So, I would like to pray for those believers that they are saying, Pastor, malayo ko, wala akong way. No, it's not. You should stand as a believer. Okay? We should stand as a believer. We should do or make ways for us to read the Word of God. So, because the Word of God is the one who gives us a strong foundation. If your faith is strong, a person can say that his faith is strong in the Lord if he reads or she reads the Word of God. If a person doesn't read the Word of God, his faith or her faith will not be strong enough. That's the truth. By the way, the Bible study in the Rehabi is not meant to offend anyone, or but these words is meant to encourage us and motivate us to remain in the Word of God. Whatever the truth, we shall know the truth, and the truth shall set us free. Alright, number 3, the last one. Okay? This is what I like, okay? Maybe we are steadfast. Sorry. We are faithful in God. Maybe we are unshakable, but we should not neglect the third one. The third one is always abounding in the work of the Lord. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. Abounding means plentiful. Plentiful means you're not just working in a specific work that God had called you might be, but we should work in other works that God might allow us to work as well. Meaning to say, hindi lamang, kunyari, ikaw ay na-assign ka sa pagtuturo before, hanggang doon ka na lang, no, it's not. Or na-assign ka sa pagiging praise and worship leader, doon ka na lang, no, it's not. We should find ways wherein we can serve the Lord with happiness or a joyful heart. We should be abounding, always abounding. We should be plentiful in doing. One should take every opportunity to serve as a blessing. This is something that I really putting it in my heart. If God gave you something to work with, you should be happy with that. And you should take this as an opportunity for you to serve the Lord. And that is a blessing. Sometimes I feel sad when I see some people that I will assign, for example, to pray. For example, let's say in a prayer meeting. And they will say, Pastor, I cannot pray because prayer or praying is not my forte. I can only teach the Word of God, but I cannot pray as of the moment. No, it's not. As believers, we should know how to pray. We should know how to lead in prayer as well. Because leading in prayer, once you are being assigned to lead in prayer, you are on the front line. You are taking this opportunity to serve God in your life. Imagine leading people into the presence of God. That is a privilege. So, ito po ay pribilehiyo natin na ma-assign tayo. Many are having many are trying to avoid to be assigned for a work to be done. Minsan, natatakot tayo or nangingimi tayong gawin ito kasi feeling natin hindi natin kaya. Wala namang ibibigay ang Panginoong Diyos sa atin na hindi natin makakaya. Sometimes we can pray, but sometimes people will avoid sharing the word or teaching the word or preaching the word because they say, I'm a prayerful or I am a prayer warrior. No, it's not. Praying is one work. Teaching is one work. Preaching is one work. That if we can do a lot of things, then much better. Because we are pleasing God, not man. Or not ourselves. Okay? So, make every effort to serve the Lord by any means with gladness. The Word of God says, in Psalm chapter 2, I remember when I meditated this word. Okay? In Psalm chapter 2, you will open your Bible. I pray that you are taking notes. Some of you are taking notes of what we are discussing. Why taking notes is very important. Bakit kailangan na tayo ay nagte-take notes? Kasi minsan nakakalimutan natin. We tend to forget the things that we are listening with. Taking notes, you can go back to your notes and remember the things that you are being taught with. Psalm chapter 2. Okay? Verse 11, serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Ang paglilingkod pala sa Panginoon, I'm talking about serving God, abounding in the word. Serving God with fear, with holy fear and trembling. What do you mean by that? Once we are serving the Lord, we must serve Him with holy fear, meaning we should serve Him with gladness in our heart, knowing that serving God is a privilege that God has given us. We are not called to just serve, but we are called to be hearers of the word. We should activate whatever the word of the Lord is giving to us and put it into a work or service. So we should be able to, appreciate the work that God is giving to each and one of us. Maybe some of you have the guts and determination to share their testimony online. Praise the Lord for those people. Continue doing that because this is one means of abounding in the work of the Lord. So, these are the three things that we should remember. Three things. One, be steadfast, be immovable. And third, always abound in the word. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this afternoon, I hope and I pray that you will be inspired and motivated with what the one that I shared it to you. God, again, wants a change in our life. That's number one. And we should be an overcomer, living an above average life or as a believer. And third, we should continue to live a victorious life in our work in the Lord. So this afternoon, continue to serve God. No one can stop us from serving God. Not this COVID, not any pandemic, not anything in this world. Because we are serving a living God. Subok na ang Panginoon. God never leave us nor forsake us. This afternoon, I would like to pray for those who are about to watch, and I pray that God will continue to put into your hearts the sense of awareness that we should live a victorious life in Christ. Let's pray right now. Father in heaven, I would like to lift up to you, my beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, those who are watching and those who are about to watch this video, I pray that the word that they are able to hear from this will inspire them and motivate them to continue to live a victorious life by being steadfast or committed to you, to their ministry, by being immovable, by having the Word of God as their strong foundation in their life, and they will abound in the work of yours. In every way, we can serve you as long as it will please you, Father. And I pray for those fellow believers of mine, strengthen them like never before. Continue to bless their life, their families. Protect them from all the works of the enemy. Maybe some of them right now are sick. Some of them are weak. I pray that you will heal them in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will strengthen them. I pray that whatever their depression may be, or because of the things that's happening in their life, will turn into joy because they are serving a living God. Father, I pray as well for those who are continuously losing their faith in you. I pray that their faith will increase as they read the word and continue to seek you into their lives. Father, I pray that everyone will be blessed by your word. And this afternoon, I take this opportunity to declare upon them your hand, upon their families, upon their life. Continue to shield them, Father God, with your presence, and keep them safe at all times. And this is all we pray. Amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet.